not somewhere else. It's mystifying that we can forget the needs of those right in front of us and not somewhere else. And we can forget them right in front of us, and we can begin to dream of things bigger and better elsewhere. We can easily miss the opportunities that God has placed before us. This changed how I did my job. I began to see the staff, the house parents, and the students under my care as wounded, gifted, hurting, and valued by God. They were in need of affirmation, prayer, guidance, love, and encouragement. So I began to work with a different attitude, even though it was a very difficult role. Even now, I see the positions I have had outside the church and in faith-based settings as opportunities to care for those God has placed before me. One of the values we speak of at Oak Hills is that we can pursue ministry as a vocation. Some of you have. Or we can pursue vocation as a ministry. I want you to think about this. Are you pursuing ministry as your vocation? Or are you pursuing your vocation as a way to minister to those God will bring into your life? Let me help you contemplate that with a reading I found years ago that I still value. If you're doing it because no one else will, it's a job. If you're doing it to serve the Lord, it's a ministry. If you're doing it just well enough to get by, it's a job. If you're doing it to the best of your ability, it's a ministry. If you quit because someone criticized you, it was a job. If you keep on serving, it's a ministry. If you'll do it only as long as it doesn't interfere with other activities, it's a job. If you're committed to staying with it, even when it means letting go of other things, it's a ministry. If you quit because no one ever praised you or thanked you, it was a job. If you stay with it, even though no one else notices your effort, it's a ministry. If you do it because someone else said it needs to be done, it's a job. If you do it because you think it needs to be done, it's a ministry. It's hard to get excited about a job. It's almost impossible not to be excited about a ministry. An average person does a job. A great and growing person is involved in ministry. If your concern is success, it's a job. If your concern is faithfulness, it's a ministry. People will say, well done, when it's your job. The Lord will say, well done, when you complete your ministry. This weekend, as you pack up at Levo Hills and begin the next stage of your journey, you will encounter jobs you may not like. You will combat issues that will challenge your integrity. You may encounter suffering and persecution. You may long for somewhere else. Others may challenge your authority. You may have to let someone else take the credit for your efforts. Or maybe you'll be where you're supposed to be. Oh, the places you will go. So, be your name Buxbaum or Bixby or Bray, or Mordecai, Ali, and Alan O'Shea, you're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way.
Let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you for sending these graduates to Oak Hills. Thank you also for their families who have entrusted them to us. Thank you, Lord, for giving us time, faculty and staff, to spend getting to know these students, interacting with them in classes, and during mealtimes over ping pong, pool, or simply chatting in the hall. You are a gracious God. Lord, I just pray that our graduates will be bold witnesses for you and your kingdom wherever you send them, in whatever occupation you guide them. Provide them with opportunities to share your love with others, and give them the courage to follow through on these opportunities that you give them. Lord, just help them to feel and know the amazing amount of love that you have for each one of them. Help them to become godly spouses, moms and dads, co-workers, fellow laborers in the good news. Life will throw them curveballs every now and again. I just ask that you give them your wisdom as they face these difficulties. Lord, let us never forget you. You are a just God, but also a God who is gracious, compassionate, slow to anger, abounding in loving kindness and faithfulness. May these graduates go forth in the confidence and assurance that you are a worthy God to serve. Thank you, Lord.
Dr. Ware, Dr. Seepers, faculty, family, and friends, it is my privilege to present the 2017 graduating class of Oak Hills Christian College. The following students have earned their Bachelor of Arts and Science degrees.
Yeah!
Wendy Sue Shaw.